Previously on the Racial Dough Project.
This is over 7,000 square feet.
When are you guys thinking about moving
in? 2 weeks. I'm serious. Completely furnished.
Oh my god.
This is the sexiest thing I've ever seen here.
This is perfect. I'm losing my mind right now. This is your calling, babe. This is a big shoot with Kim Kardashian tomorrow. I can only take one of you.
My feeling is that we should come on this one.
You made the best decision you could have ever made possible.
The Hollywood Reporter has decided to do a cover story on the number one stylist in the world, and they picked me.
Babe, you're 9 months pregnant.
That's what they actually enjoy about it.
Tom, sorry, 9 months pregnant.
You think he's the pregnant one.
Dad's worried, I'm worried, Mom's worried, so everybody's worried, but I still have so many things that have to be done before I disappear for 2 months. For Dushan, that's probably Jeremiah. Do you feel like he's nervous for the shoot?
He should be. It's gonna be his first one.
Good morning. I come bearing gifts.
Oh my god.
What is it?
Oh my god, look at these are all candles.
Candles.
Rach, you should do your own line of home accents.
Right.
You'll ever.
Yeah. So you have to be on a phone call 2 minutes ago. Can we not talk about candles?
Wait, is this elf?
We gotta do the elf thing right now. So it's literally just gonna be me and the two of you. Because everyone else is out on other jobs. The idea is this is for first issue of summer. So we're going to focus on swim. I'm going to talk to him more about the concept right now, but roughly it's bathing suits and incredible accessories and jewels, lots and lots of jewels and incredible shoes. One of the best things about doing a photo shoot with Elle is that I have their fashion department helping me get all the looks that I requested. It's pretty mage. This is your first editorial with me. Major editorial.
Hello.
Hey, it's Rachel Zoe calling.
How are you?
I'm good, honey. How are you?
I'm good.
So what are you thinking in terms of concept? I know Joe was maybe still thinking about doing swim with, like, incredible accessories and stuff like that. I mean, is that still kind of the idea?
You know, from my conversation with Joe, he was very much into that.
But also, like, amazing shoes. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
It would be amazing if we could shoot at the Chateau Marmont pool.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
It's going to be awesome. I'm excited to work with you again. Okay, sweetie, big kiss. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
It's gonna be so good. Do you know how I get off on a great fashion story? It's not normal.
I'm excited. This is why I came to work for Rachel Zoe. This opportunity to style with her, to watch how she works. And I'm excited to finally get to learn from her.
It's probably gonna be fine jewelry mixed with incredible costume. Like, I'm sure lots of Chanel and Lanvin, stuff like that. It's kind of just a big fashion.
So into it.
Fantasy.
So
love fun. It. I love when you have, like, an insanely beautiful model and you make it about her body.
Which, well, she's gonna be.
She has a real body. She's not like a scarecrow, you know what I mean? She's like
bombshell gorgeous.
We're basically gonna be staring at her naked wearing $1 billion worth of diamonds.
Yeah, something like that.
Best day ever.
Can you be in the body image issue naked holding your baby?
Oh my god, Joey. Yes, exactly what I want to do. I want to stand next to a model all day, over 9 months pregnant, in heels, like with a basketball in my stomach.
In the sun.
This is going to be a real, like, ego boost for me, just saying. Boys are dismissed. What an idea.
Bye.
Nothing. I'm just so exhausted. I left the office. I'm going home. I saw your car.
Just a rough day?
No, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. I'm so tired, dude. I can't wait to have one of these myself.
Your wife works a lot. Like, I'm just a little concerned because Rach literally working all day.
First and foremost, worried about her being healthy and the baby coming out healthy. She's on her feet all day. I don't think that's something that a pregnant person, you know, is supposed to be doing. I mean, I don't know. Should they?
I mean, Keisha worked up until the day she had our kids.
The doctor doesn't seem to be too concerned. It's more about me just being, like, a first-time father. I don't know.
Well, then I think you gotta figure out what it is. Maybe it's you. Maybe it's not Rachel.
What I don't want to have happen is I don't want to be, like, Mr. Mom, because I think I could easily see that happening. I don't know what I'm gonna do, bro.
Just go with it. Let her do whatever she wants, because she's gonna do it anyway.
Obviously, that's my girl.
You don't yell at her, because that's not gonna get you anywhere.
That's what everyone keeps saying.
Just suck
it makes
up.
Me feel better.
What's that all about?
It's sinking in that I'm going to be responsible for a person. We're going to be responsible for a person that needs us and looks to us for everything. And, you know, I just hope I'm going to do a good job.
You got a lot to deal with, my friend.
Yes. Hello?
Is it?
Hi, honey.
Hi.
What are you wearing today?
I know, I look at the homeless.
You're giving me, like, MK and Ashley.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm not feeling that fantastic.
What do you mean?
I just think I'm tired and run down.
You're already run down?
No, I'm not. Don't say anything to anybody.
I got an email from Rachel about some stuff for the L shoot.
Obviously, I don't like being left out of the emails between Rachel and Joey. I understand that they're best friends, and I might be a little bit sensitive about it, but I don't want to be left out.
We need to find out what's happening with the shoes. I know the jewelry and the clothes are being prepped in New York and then being sent here. We need to be on top of all of our because Rachel is gonna give birth on the L shoot. And we need to make sure the mucus plug does not fling at the model. Trying to make it funny and it just keeps disgusting me.
Do you think this will fit in somewhere?
I feel like you need to wear that right now.
This is for the evening. This is daytime. Evening.
So we basically just need her to tell us what she needs us to prep, like shoes and clutches or scarves or anything from the studio.
So let's pull shoes. I don't think we're gonna need scarves. It's beach.
We're gonna need everything. The more ridiculous something is, the more prone she is to using it.
I'm excited. I've never seen firsthand Rachel in a photo shoot, but she gets so passionate over just looking at a dress on a computer screen. I can only imagine how she is when she gets to lube up a model and throw some jewels on her.
But wait, I just got an email.
What does it say?
It's just a PDF of the looks for the shoot and what it's gonna look like.
Why aren't I on any of these emails?
I thought you were, though. You were on the first few.
Yeah, but I'm not on any of these ones that you're getting now. Are they coming from Rachel?
She's just forwarding, like, everyone that's on, like, reply
all. I'll just tell her to forward it to me as well.
I'll just forward it to you. Don't ask her to do anything. We could barely even get her on the phone. It's fine. You're coming to the shoot. I told her we need you. So we have, like, 24 hours for this shoot to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Just be on top of things. Always be calm. Don't ever complain about one thing that's not there. Don't, like, react to her.
Okay.
Don't react to what she's complaining about, or don't even say, oh, that sucks. I have to jump on this other call, so I'm going to go into the other office. I'll see you in a little bit.
Honey. Sounds good.
Bye.
Bye. Where is the Chanel and Lanvin jewelry?
It should be here.
But it's not. I haven't found it yet. They're sending stuff. I just want to have some backups because options.
Okay, we're in color.
I know. Well, kind of. It's on your legs. It's a start.
So it's at the chateau, right?
Yeah. I mean, allegedly. You know, I'm not on the emails.
Oh, Rachel?
All the emails that are going around.
That's just who Rachel is. I wouldn't take it personally.
Yeah, I mean, look, I was on the emails initially. I'm not taking it personally. I think I'm just that much of a... it's going to take me a while to become part of the family in the conversation.
It takes time.
These brown ones are amazing.
So you're going. That's a step in the right direction.
I'm really excited. This is what I've been waiting for, is it gets the chance to actually work with her on a job. So what can I mean, points? Do you have any ideas?
Rachel hates when people are sitting around. Like, make sure that you're really busy. Make sure that you're on top of everything. And it'll take you, like, a while to keep being amazing until it actually processes it in her head.
I'll work my ass off. I always do.
She obviously knows that you're capable and competent and you've done a good job. You just have to keep showing her that in everything that you do, because I don't think we still really know what you're going to end up doing here.
Yeah,
anyway.
And this is a great opportunity for me to show her that I'm competent in other areas besides home.
I'm just going to go back to my office. But if you need anything, let me know.
Yeah, of course. I'm just going to sit here and play with shoes.
Okay, bye. Hug you, but I don't want to get sick.
Yeah, don't hug me.
Bye.
I'm sweaty and cold. Bye, thank you. Talking to Madonna really helped. I'm obviously still really nervous about tomorrow, but I'm gonna go home, get some rest, and be 100%. This one's great.
Okay, so Rachel's going to be here in 10 minutes. We need to find a home for the bags and accessories. Mm-hmm. We need to go through the racks and try to make some type of order of everything.
Yeah.
Shoo-ba-da-ba-ba-boo. Today is the Elle Magazine bathing suit photo shoot. I'm really excited that I brought those 20 pairs of shoes and was stressing out over them because next to the 300 that Elle sent, I think we're covered with shoes for today. I'm actually really happy that Rachel had Jordan come help me for the first couple hours of setup because there are so many clothes here. It's overwhelming. Rachel's gonna be here any minute, and the showpiece jewelry is, of course, missing. I have to find it because I'm the one responsible if anything goes wrong. Ugh. This is a nightmare. Where is the Chanel Amon Von jewelry?
It should be here.
But it's not. I haven't found it yet.
Thanks for riding with me, Joey.
You're welcome.
My mother got me all paranoid that I should never be alone in a car.
Your husband made me paranoid, like I had to be with you at all times.
Well, because it's like tomorrow is actually week 37.
That's insane.
I'm 9 months and 1 week pregnant.
Well, see, to me, it only counts when you show. So you would literally have a 2 month pregnancy.
I'm like a snake that swallowed a basketball. I think it's to be expected, Joey, that I'm 37 weeks pregnant and I'm about to go on a 12-hour photo shoot.
I'm going through all the swimsuits for the shoot today.
There's some really, really good stuff.
There is, like, amazing things
in here. Yeah, it's kind of amazing.
I'm super excited about it.
I am, too. And I'm so glad we're shooting at Chateau. It's a location I wanted. I just didn't know if it would come through, if it would be available. I spoke to Josie last night. He's in Paris. And we were just talking about how we want, like, you know, we still want, like, sexy kind of,
well,
you know, sexy
somewhere.
Hair. Right, but we don't want it to get too kind of like Marlena Dietrich in 1930s. So we want it to have elements of that with like the one pieces, but like, and like a fierce lip maybe, but
well, you know,
it's still going to have like Pucci and headscarves and stuff like that.
Honey, you know Danila is going to give you like a hairstyle that's like this escalated.
I know, which I kind of love.
What heels are you wearing today? Givenchy wedges?
Uh-huh.
You're like a pregnant whore. Like, how do you ever, like, don't your feet hurt?
Not yet.
You're like in hooker heels.
At least it's a wedge, so I have support.
I haven't found it yet. I'm sure it's here somewhere. I'm freaking out because Rachel's two favorite jewelry designers, Chanel and Lanvin, are missing, and they have to be here before she arrives. Boom! The Lanvin jewelry. Somebody's keeping their job. Excuse me. Look what I found. The missing Lanvin and Chanel stuff. So we should have everything now, right?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
It's heavier than the model.
It's just a little summertime necklace. Just laying out by the pool.
In my bikini in that, right? Hi, guys.
Hey.
Hi. Oh, my goodness. Working with bathing suits, it just takes on a whole new kind of thing because I can just add tons and tons of jewelry and total hooker heels and like great head wraps and sunnies. It's all about the accessories, basically.
Rachel, you might be mad at me.
What?
I got a ring stand on my finger.
Of course you did. You're such a trans.
And it's the biggest trans
and the
ring in the whole
biggest
world.
One ever. I brought my good camera.
Oh, is this for my photographer duty?
Yeah, because you're the only one responsible enough to take photos.
I just feel like you're treating me like I'm Roger now.
Well, you're a Libra, and you're the closest thing after Roger, so guess what? When he's not here, you are Uncle Joey.
That's why you love me.
I don't know. It's a Libra thing, and you guys can both be moody bitches when you want to be, too. Okay, boys, so I have Jordan here just to kind of start you guys off, just because there's a ton of stuff. I thought they were actually exaggerating, but I have to tell you, Elle turned this out. Like, it's going to be a really tough edit because everything is really amazing, but we can't shoot the same designer more than once. So, like, if there's three amazing Dolce looks, I have to pick one.
Okay.
To spread the love. Oh, hi. Hi. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Happy?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, clothes make me happy. It's going to be a tough edit, I'm not going to lie. kind of goes on for days. So I'll do a little bit of a tighter edit even. Yeah. Take this one out. This kind of looks very Halston-y to me. This is not happening. Take this guy out. Keep it on standby. This is just too heavy. Mm-hmm. This whole Mark look is too covered. Not gonna use this one. This has to happen. Yeah, totes. It'll just be like one of these with like a ton of major jewels. God, this is overwhelming. It's like a good overwhelming. Styling an editorial is one of my most favorite parts of my job. It's like the fantasy of it all. You're working with a model, you're working with the best clothes and fashion, and I'm creating beautiful images. The fun part. We need white.
We have this chunky silver, like the big bracelets. And the bracelets.
So Dusan is like, showed me some Marlena Dietrich inspirations, and we talked about a like coral red mouth.
Yeah, it's going to be something of a mix of 30s meets 70s, 60s. So it's going to be, you know, not too Marlena Dietrich, but your
a little hint not to the 60s, 70s.
Exactly.
Yeah,
you got it.
All that beautiful editing.
Yeah.
Trying to figure out.
Yeah,
totally. I think this is how a rich woman would wear it.
So cool. Original.
Well, it's definitely.
I like it. Wow. It's kind of major, huh?
It's so good.
It's amazing.
I don't think she even needs a hat.
Oh, I like it.
That's perfect. Yeah, I love it.
Obviously.
I love you so much, Joey.
Just get to the top position right now.
Watch your step, clumsy.
Oh my gosh. Are you okay, Liv? I wish I could get in there, but I can't.
Come on, you want to give it a go?
You know, if I was not 9 months, I would be crawling up in there right now. Can you take the earrings off for a sec? Better. No earring, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it's more about the collar and the cuff. Is it possible for you to pull the straps like, so they crisscross? Yeah, I would do it myself, but I'm a control freak. But I have to say that being very pregnant and realizing that I can't physically do all the things that I'm used to doing has been a little hard for me to accept. Oh, we're leaving the spot.
Yes, going down to the pool.
Fabulous.
Okay. I got the shoes, don't worry, Rachel.
I just love this look because I love a colorful knit. The way Marc Jacobs did it is just kind of the perfect way to do a knit in a sexy way for summertime. Just like really colorful with a big wide brim hat and super short shorts. Do you think the circles are supposed to be more strategically on her boobies? Your boobs just went up to your chin, love.
Can I tuck your scarf in?
Can you go get me a Bloody Mary? Give me a Luke. Oh, sexy. You're like Brigitte Bardot pregnant. Oh my God, I love it. Give me another one. Perfect.
I'm not here to be Rachel's friend. If Joey wants to make her laugh and joke around, Joey can do that. I just started with her, and I need to work my ass off and hope that she recognizes that I am the right person for the job. So that's all I'm doing.
This one I forgot.
Do you know what, I should prep for next?
I think we should do the Vuitton.
Okay. I'm going to start getting it ready, then.
Are we done with this one?
Ugh, that necklace. Can you pull it forward?
I mean, I think when you add an extremely large, incredible necklace, like the Lanvin necklace, against a Louis Vuitton bodysuit and hot pants, it's not just everything. Like when she's holding it, it's kind of cool. I mean,
do you want to sit up a little bit?
Well, I mean, shoot it how you like. If she holds it, it's cool. I mean, it looks like, you know, that's kind of gorge. Not gonna lie. I should make sure the story makes sense.
I think it does.
Do my looks make sense?
Yeah.
Because, you know, with pregnancy brain, I just want to make sure everything.
They gave her so much pop of color
right.
On the floor.
Right, it's going to make sense.
Yeah, she's like on a magic carpet, looking like a hookah. You made a good choice.
I love you so much, Joey. You have no idea.
Do we have anything we can accessorize a little bit more with?
Head scarf or something?
Or a hat.
Yeah,
or
head scarf, hat. Yeah.
Put the visor on.
We have scissors.
Let's try the visor.
I don't think she even needs a hat.
Oh, I like it.
That's nice. Stay there. Yeah, so I see the nails. Good.
I like it. It's going to be a fan favorite.
I love having Joey with me on set. He's actually a really good stylist. He makes me laugh, but he also gets everything done.
It's cool. It is cool. Where is she going?
Charlie, just at 101, Maya. Always be on the towels in a row.
Obviously.
Got it.
If you have to think too much when on set at a photo shoot, you're probably not a natural. Things should just kind of feel easy. You should just really know what to do. You should have that instinct that, like, something needs to be done and you do it.
That's perfect. Yeah, I love it.
This look is very L. You know what's the funnest part about a photo shoot with you?
Yeah.
It's like reading your mind when I see all the clothes and the shoes. We have a telepathic relationship.
Yeah, we do. The Dolce & Gabbana one piece is kind of that very Esther Williams / Marilyn Monroe type of bathing suit that kind of never goes out of style, but right now has really come back in fashion. Do you think you have this one, babe? Okay, so you know how this was supposed to be my last shoot before I retire?
Yeah.
Well, my team really wants me to do this shoot tomorrow for the Hollywood Reporter because they're doing, like, something on, like, the top stylists in the world, and they want me on the cover.
Why wouldn't you do it? You could be pregnant with quintuplets and still style a whole freaking country if you wanted to.
Do you think I should do it?
Yes.
You do?
Absolutely. Obviously, I don't think you've ever been on a cover of a magazine before for a positive reason.
Roger wasn't happy the first time I told him about the Hollywood Reporter shoot, but it's a really big opportunity, and it's important for my career, so he's going to have to just get over it. Thanks, you guys.
It was really fun. I feel like every look was so major.
I mean, Joey, I'm always giving you my personal camera because I would never get half the shots because I can't stay on top of it, you know?
My success at Rachel Zoe, Inc. is contingent upon me finding a place to fit in. I'm not quite sure that this jack-of-all-trades bouncing around thing is going to work.
Peanut thanks you guys because I got to sit during the shoot, which I never do.
Please go home and lay down.
Soon. Doing a photo shoot this pregnant is beyond exhausting. I have one look left, the Balenciaga, and then I'm done. Thank God. Technically, after my next shoot, I'll be retired.
Thanks, Lansmore.
I still don't believe you.
That's what you said today.
But I love it.
It was a great shoot. And it's a great way for me to go out because I'm, like, still fashion obsessed, twisted, crazy bitch.
The shoot is so much fun. I love your job.
And it's like the perfect shoot to kind of start my sabbatical.
Even though you have another shoot.
But that one's on me. It's
different. Love shoots. They're so much fun. I get to treat people like Barbie.
That's what I'm saying. Like, what do I have to complain about? It's everything. Oh my God, she's in the water.
Oh my God, we have to go down.
I'm so glad we had a place for this swimsuit. I was hoping there was a place for it.
Chat for a second.
What's up?
I wanted to talk to you about the future.
Yes. Ooh.
Sounds very ominous.
It does.
The reality is that a lot of these other departments are running at tip-top shape, right. And they're doing this and this and this, and so I felt weird. But doing the house project, I felt like myself, and I liked, you know, running the project and handling and coordinating.
Well, because it's like your niche. It's your thing.
Yeah. I'm going to try and see. I came to you first.
Mm-hmm.
But see about how possible it is to kind of transition to maybe creating and cultivating Rachel Zoe Home. I know it's a huge, huge step, and there's a lot involved to it. I've been struggling since I started at Rachel Zoe to find a place for myself. And home seems like a natural progression for her and the company, something that I can help them with, that I can do, and I can actually run it. And I have a place, and I have something that I know I'm good at.
The thing with home is it's definitely something that's on our brand agenda.
Yeah.
But it's probably a few years down the line because we're a really new brand and we just launched our first apparel collection. So
yeah.
I think it's an amazing idea and it's something that we really want to do. But I wonder if it's a little soon.
There's so many different divisions of home, you know, but I think accents and stuff feels like a natural and a smart first step.
Again, I don't know where it fits in with our company timeline. Totally. So I think it's a much bigger conversation, even though it's an amazing idea. Like something we've been thinking about doing.
I mean, I know at the end of the day that home, I could do single-handedly and just nail it.
I have no doubt. Let me talk to the team about it and see where we stand as a company.
Yeah.
And then we'll circle back and talk about how we can move forward if we're ready.
I want to have a purpose and I want to have a clear plan of action.
But as a company, we need to figure out if we have the need. And I think that's where we stand.
I got to deal with Shabaya. When this little bundle of joy comes out, I don't know how you're going to feel it. I don't know where we're going to go. I don't know what we're going to expand to.
Can you revise 4 and 5? Because they're just going to be a problem. You know what I mean? Okay. Bye.
Hey.
Hi.
Do you have anything for me to do? Please tell me that you do.
Yes, I have 500 things to do that I can't do myself. I just don't think there's anything you can do. I don't know. I have to get through these contracts, which I don't really know how you're going to help. Are you good on Excel?
No.
Are you good on PowerPoint?
No.
Do you know how to use a computer?
Barely. Leave me alone. I build stuff.
The fact that the kid doesn't know how to use a computer, I actually don't have words for him right now. Like, I don't, like, I can't help you. Sorry.
Let me answer it.
Oh my God, today is your last photo shoot. Yeah. Officially, right?
Today I'm being shot for the cover of The Hollywood Reporter. It's my first cover shoot ever. I am beyond exhausted, and I'm just now starting to realize I need to take a break. You have to do my makeup for the hospital.
What?
Well, I mean, I feel like we have to anticipate.
If your water breaks at 3 a.m. and I have to come here to do your makeup, weirdest thing in the whole world.
I'm gonna have to have a red lip.
You're a freak.
I got this new long Chanel duster cardigan that I think would be good for the hospital trip.
I'm so excited.
Is that right?
I feel like you're all prepared and ready to go.
I haven't packed a bag yet.
Are you gonna wear it the whole time you're giving birth?
No. I don't want to get rid of it.
Oh, are you gonna ever, like, would you ever let them put that, like, hospital thing on you?
Ew.
It's so ugly. And then everyone's gonna see your butt.
No one's gonna see my butt.
Are you so nervous the doctor's gonna see your butt?
I don't care about the doctor. I just don't want Roger to see my butt. But, like...
You're just not normal.
Why?
Like, how do you have the perfect pregnancy?
I don't.
I feel like you really do have it all. You have a closet full of clothes that any woman would die over. You have a husband who's obsessed with you that any woman would die to have. You had the easiest pregnancy in the world and...
Yeah, but I could have a brutal
and memory. A career that anyone would kill for.
I really don't know. Maybe this was a little reward for, like, I never asked anyone to help me. I never got favors from anybody. Maybe, like, having a good pregnancy was kind of like, you know, someone up there just being like, okay... You've given blood, sweat, and tears for your career, so we're going to kind of make this a good experience for you. But it's not over yet, so I don't want to jinx it. I'm Jewish. And a Virgo, so I'm double paranoid. Hi there.
What's up?
Pulling up my schedule.
I'm losing it. So I just want to make sure we're on top of things. And there's just so much money going out of this company that I really need to make sure that it's...
Yeah, I hear you.
Being spent on
speaking
the
of,
stuff.
We need to discuss Jeremiah in terms of employee status because he's out.
It's been on my mind.
He's interested in doing a Rachel's at Home line.
Sitting here right now, today, I don't think there's not much for him to do. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if people are ready to do home.
No.
Like, I don't think we're ready to be Bed Bath & Beyond. The brand's not big enough.
I agree.
That it could absorb... that right now. I don't think that we can fund it. I just don't. There's just too much going on. And as good as I think he is and as talented as I think he is, I honestly don't know what he's going to do day to day. I've been concerned about Jeremiah since day one because, honestly, he's not a stylist and he needs to be trained. And Rachel does not have the time to train him like she normally would. If he can't be a stylist right now, you know, what is he going to do here? It's one of those things. It's almost like, do we want to adopt another child now?
Right.
I'm having a real child, and the money, and that's going to be my number one priority. I mean, I got to provide for that kid,
yeah,
no matter what. Then all my other kids.
It sucks, because I really like Jeremiah a lot, and he's fun to work with, but...
He's great. I'm just very afraid to commit to anything. I do not know how Rachel's going to react
when
she has this child. She may just want to be a mommy. Mm-hmm. Maybe, you know, I don't think that's Rachel, but listen, stranger things have happened. So I'm sort of trying to keep... our cost structure a little lower now?
I just think we'll sit down and we'll have to explain that to him. But the question is, how's Rachel gonna feel about letting him go?
I don't know.
Hey,
it's not even cute when I'm not pregnant.
And what about this? It's tight.
It's a shirt.
I know.
That's not gonna work. That's a lining. It buckles in at the waist. Forgot about it. I have to find things in my closet that not only are, like, really special and spectacular and all that and super fashion-y and over the top, but they have to actually fit around my stomach, which is massive right now. Oh, wait, Joey. You're looking a little more the other week. Where that? She's upstairs, and I'm gonna go see how she's doing with wardrobe.
Okay, great. I'll go set up outside.
Cool. Oh my gosh, I'm obsessed with this look, Joe. It's so pretty.
You look like you just spent all your husband's money.
Have you ever worn this before?
No.
Vintage Halston sequins, tiger. This is like from 1974. You look so good. I just want to touch him. Do I look fat or just pregnant?
No, you look pregnant. Are you kidding me?
I can't even believe that's a question.
It's so typical that my first cover shoot would be when I'm, like, 39 and a half weeks pregnant. Not in the best shape, but thank God my friend Doug is shooting it because it makes me a little more comfortable.
So this is kind of going to be your spot. You look gorgeous.
You're sweet.
It's ironic that you would do your first cover shoot 9 months pregnant.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That's fun.
I'm just so tired that, like, I don't care. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? I'm, like, so tired.
So tired.
Love. Take a step towards Joey.
Like?
Yeah, like right there. Perfect. That's it.
Beautiful, Rachel. Stunning. Look right here. Bring your face a little bit straight at me.
Oh.
That's it. Hold on 1 second. It's amazing. Okay.
I got very lucky that I didn't have to wear any maternity clothes during my pregnancy. But I'm not gonna lie, I'm really testing the seams on these dresses.
Turn the back shoulder back. Yeah, that's it. Just like that. A little smile. That's it. It's gorgeous. Love it.
The fact that I'm on the cover of a magazine in a vintage Halston gown, it's like that's a moment that I'm always going to reflect on. And I think I'll be really proud of it later on in my life and show my son.
Keep the lips together and really relax. Just let them touch. That's it. Beautiful. Think of something a little bitchy. Chin down a little bit. That's it. A little smile, a little wink, and there it is. That's it.
I'll do what Douglas wants. What does Doug want?
He wants to in crumpled evening wear. So he wants
what's tux. Formal, but like out of a form.
Right, like you just got home.
They kind of sprung it on me last minute that I was going to be in this thing. Luckily, I'm married to a stylist, and I have lots of choices. That, tux shirt,
good.
Tuxedo pants, pantaloons, which is straight, very nice.
Beautiful.
My lime vein, pant shoes.
Perfect. Oh my gosh, perfect.
Joey, will you get the other sleeve?
Sure. Roger needs more attention than Rachel.
Obviously.
He's so much more heavy.
It's not messy enough.
In case anyone was wondering, there's intense heat coming through the window and magnifying on my back.
Okay, we're going.
So.
I swear we're going right now.
Look at where I'm looking.
You're looking at me.
Oh, hi. Just chilling out of my house for no apparent reason, leaning against the window.
That's lovely.
I'm flirting with the cat.
Beautiful. Smize, Roger, smize.
Don't do that. They're going to use that.
Oh, my God. He just got a cramp.
I told you. High maintenance. So dramatic.
Beautiful. Oh.
I couldn't resist.
Can look here. Beautiful, Rachel. Rachel, hold Roger's arm. That's it. Beautiful.
I have to admit, I was completely against Rachel doing a photo shoot at 9 months pregnant. But seeing her on set, she's smiling and she's lit up and she's so proud of, you know, her being pregnant and just getting the opportunity to be on the cover. So, I don't know. I guess it's the right idea. But this had better be the last photo shoot.
Hey, love. I have to go do this last shot.
I know, you look exhausted.
Yeah, my body's like, this is like the last hurrah.
I know.
I'm done now.
I know. So, I know this isn't the right time, but I feel terrible. We gotta deal with what we're gonna do with Jeremiah. I mean, everything's sort of done here.
I know.
And
look, I mean, this is definitely something I need you to really take the lead on. It's employee, whatever. But I think at the end of the day, I love and adore him. I honestly think he's amazing. He's super talented, and I could think of a myriad of projects that we have for him. honestly, I'm really pregnant right now. I have a million things going on. I don't want Jeremiah to leave. And if Roger really thinks that there's nothing for him to do and he's going to have to fire him, he's going to have to deal with that. I honestly can't deal with this right now.
Listen, I know you like your people around, you know? Your creative geniuses around you. But
I like to nourish talent, you know what I mean? And he's fairly very talented.
He's very talented, very, very talented. And I think I'd love to do business with him. I'd love to do things with
him. It's just the timing is off.
No, and also, I don't know when this little bundle of joy comes out, you know? I don't know how you're going to feel it. I don't know where we're going to go. I don't know what we're going to expand to.
Well, I'm going to leave it to you because I'm too, you know, everything to me is too personal.
All right.
You got to be bad cop. I got to go. Right. I got to go finish it.
Love you.
That was an air kiss because Joey will kill me.
All right. Good luck. Rachel, stand here so your face is in the sun. Put your left leg out and then bring your right leg back. Look out the window, straight ahead.
It's so pretty.
Relax your mouth, keep your lips together. Think of something happy and sexy. That's it. Turn your face a bit towards me. Beautiful. And look here. Beautiful. Rachel, hold the baby again like that.
Beautiful.
That's it. Yeah,
beautiful.
That's it.
The gold and white sequin kind of 1920s beaded dress is one of my favorite vintage pieces. And sometimes I find I can't wear it because it's a little bit too big and it kind of weighs me down. But the cut just works on my pregnant belly.
Soothing. That's it. Relaxing. Look into the corner of the room. That's it. Right? And look at your baby. Oh, that's beautiful. That's it. Hold that. I think we lost the light. We good? Rachel, we're done.
It's a wrap.
It's a wrap, everyone. Beautiful. Do you want to see?
Yeah. Oh, cute. It's really cute. That you'll straighten. Yeah. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you, Rachel.
Everybody.
Thank you.
Peanuts moving. Sophie's saying thanks. Little man. Good night, Uncle Dad.
Thank you.
The shoot went great, but now I think I actually have to wrap my head around the fact that I'm about to become a mother. I'm a little freaked out. I'm not going to lie.
There's no two ways about it. I thought I was going to come in here today, and you're going to look at me and be like, you've been working your ass off. We get it. You're dedicated. You get the job done.
Yes, you're the home authority of a company that doesn't do anything at home.
Hey.
What's up, Maya?
What's up?
What's happening?
Are we doing the pound?
Sure, whatever you want to do.
I'm really excited that I'm finally getting the opportunity to sit down with Roger. In the back of my mind, I'm thinking, this is it. He's going to tell me, Jeremiah, you were so right. Rachel Zohom is the perfect transition for the brand, and you're the right guy to do it. Here it is. Make it happen.
I want to talk. You know, we got to figure out what's going on. Rachel's going to give, you know, birth momentarily. And then the question is, you know, what goes on with, you know, Jeremiah? What's going on now? Is our expenses and everything are gonna go like this. I don't know where Rachel's head is at in terms of work, you know, and I don't know what she's gonna do in the future. And there's nothing really on a day-to-day for you to do here.
The thing is when you guys brought me in here, it was for the Jer of all trades and to do everything.
Right.
Reality is I didn't get a chance to do everything. I mean, that's just the truth. The house happened, that took up a tremendous amount of time.
But the house, I mean, it was amazing what you did. We couldn't appreciate it more. But now I shifted to business mode. Home right now is exactly $0 of our business.
Look, I thought that there's no two ways about it. I thought I was going to come in here today and you're going to look at me and be like, you've been working your ass off for the last whatever time we've seen. I mean, you slept on the floor. Like, we get it. You're dedicated. You get the job done. We know we can trust you with any task.
Yes, you're the home authority of a company that doesn't do anything at home. You know, I think initially when you came here, the idea is, you know, I love style, I want to be a stylist. But I think that you're fooling yourself a little bit if you think that it's in your blood.
I haven't even really done styling because I haven't had really the opportunity to do anything. I mean, there's been shoots and pulls that I've never even brought in on the actual shoot to do the stuff with. I mean, look, there's no...
I think you're extremely talented, and I just have a philosophy, like, if you're talented, you gotta go with what you're good at. In my opinion, this is just my opinion. I've spent many, many, many hours thinking about this. I really have, because I didn't want this to be the answer, to be honest. I really didn't. But I think the bottom line is today, here and now,
It's the day-to-day just is going to probably have to end. Rachel about any jobs. Nothing. She needs to just get her mind off everything.
I think that you need to, like, stop wallowing. Because I personally, I don't feel bad for you.
No, but I don't think I'm wallowing. I think I'm just trying to take it all in.
Okay.
Molly, do you think we need to dress up for this art opening?
Yeah. Is the event here in L.A.?
No, it's in New York.
Oh.
Yeah.
This one, too, if you wanted to go for...
No.
This one is kind of sexy.
No.
Oh, my God. She doesn't like anything. Will we have time for me to fluff your hair and makeup?
100%.
Oh, my God.